iPhone 6 DDR Reball using WL tool. We shared it on our site. So after I placed the stencil on the DDR, clean it and dry without any flux. Please note this is an old video with narration recorded at this time, as I have begin adding the paste on the stencil using my finger, because I think this is the best way to spread the paste in an equal amount. When you use some metallic tool, I don't know how it's named, that tool, it presses the paste to the stencil in such a way that it damages the small balls and you get some hard stuck sheet, and the solder is not equal on in all holes. And I begin to heat using 260 of temp, full airflow. This stencil is good, the foil tool, but there is one, how to say, there is one disadvantage. It lifts at the right side, where is the edge of the stencil. This is because the it's not made precise, and the magnet does not stick the whole metallic stencil. I have used a tweezer on the right to keep it stick, so it's not lifting. But in general, this stencil is very good for reballing. I already used it to fix dead devices and recover the data. And I have observed that not all balls have stick to the DDR pads. You will see that I will press them with my cleaning tool that I use to clean black resin between components. As you can see, some balls, they are not soldered, and I will have to press them inside and add flux also to make them stick. You might not see the heat gun on the left, but I use it. You can see bubbles from the flux because there is heat. I heat it. This video is old and I decided to record narration and upload to my YouTube channel. So maybe you will learn something useful. I tried adding balls, ready balls, if you know, to reball, but I have cut that part of the video. It's impossible to add balls to the stencil because they are bigger. Maybe if they were smaller, somewhere the size of 0.2, but I was adding 0.25 of 1 millimeter. As you can see, there are a couple of this type of bolts which did not stick to the RAM pads. Again, pressing the stencil, making sure that each ball is soldered well. Many people are repeating the same questions. What flux you used? The flux is made in Ukraine. It's named flux F4 or F3. F4 have more rosin, but F3 have less rosin. There is also available, I don't remember proper, or F1 or F5, which I use to clean the soldering iron tip. It's transparent, but it's not good to solder the components. I think that it can make low shorts if you use that type of flux. So I have cleaned the flux from the stencil and looking if there is any other bolt that did not solder. As you can see, I don't remember good the video. If the bolts are not enough big, you can apply second time solder paste to make them even bigger. Because for the pop RAM it's needed to have big bolts so it will touch the top of the CPU pads. So this procedure is required, but then it will came a little bit harder. The stencil will came out a little bit harder because the balls are big, but the holes are not made for big balls. That's the problem. I have some ideas for stencils, but I don't want to publish them because, as always, I don't get any recognition. I'm tired to give them ideas so everyone use, but no one remembers who the fuck gave that idea. Perfect. This is perfect. I soldered this. I have reballed the CPU and this RAM on a pony where I have recovered the data. And the pony is working. We have soldered it already. Yes, I can do the hand reball, but I have preferred to do with stencil because it's important between the CPU and DDR. The balls are important to be even of the same size. I still think that behind the ball it's possible to do and no need any stencil, but it takes time and I don't have stability in my hands as before, so I tremble. That's the reason I prefer it stencil over hand reball. So now I think I'm separating the stencil from the CPU, from the DDR. You can see that balls are big and the stencil does not get easy out because I have applied 2 times solder paste to make them bigger. I will hit again the solder so the balls will melt. This will help to get it out of the stencil. I mean to remove the DDR from the stencil in such cases with big balls. It even can automatically a little bit move out of the stencil. I'm not sure if you see this in the video, but you can see in corner already. Also the flux is sticking it to the stencil. It's important to clean always the flux to reduce its amount. Also, you can bend the stencil a little bit when you have such cases with big balls, and it will help to get the ink that you are reballing easier. Heating with low temp, I don't remember which temp I used, but I think it was somewhere 150 of Celsius. See, there is flux. I didn't clean it all, but it helped to clean. And the temp that I used also helped to soften this flux that is hiding under the RAM and stencil, between the RAM and stencil, cleaning everything. so that for next use for next usage it will be clean. After I take off the ink from the stencil, it does not matter what ink it is. I add again flux and hit the balls so they will move into the proper place. They will align. This is the last hit before I place the ink on the CPU or on the logic board. You can observe from the video how the balls move. And now the last step that you may not know, or maybe someone told you. Now is cleaning the flux from the middle of the DDR. Because if you leave flux in the middle of the CPU and DDR, or if you add such, it will boil and the ink will not solder on all balls. This is a mistake that a lot of technicians do. I have found this problem from the Nokia old Honest, that I should clean the flux from the middle and leave it only where all are the balls. That's it, people. I hope you have enjoyed this video. Please share, subscribe, like, comment, and spread the word. And don't forget to give recognition and credits. This is very positive feeling. Goodbye.